If there was one thing you could do to lose body fat, would you do it? It is actually pretty simple. But in this video, I am going to give you some tips so that you can incorporate it into your life without it causing you too much stress. It is not going to be a secret hack or loophole you can use to get miracle results, but it could make the difference in helping you lose a few extra kilos. The main issue most people have when losing weight is that they start out well, but very quickly find themselves at a plateau. At this plateau, most of us often give up. When you are losing weight, you essentially are trying to get rid of excess body fat. Excess body fat is nothing but stores of excess energy. Excess energy your body feels it might need in the days of a famine. Storage of body fat in the body follows a simple rule of Chico. Calories in, calories out. If the calories in is equal to the calories out, you will maintain your weight. If the calories in is more than your calories out, you will gain weight. And if your calories in is less than your calories out, you will lose weight. You control calories in by regulating how much you eat, and you control calories out by manipulating your activity levels. Since we are trying to lose weight, we would like to increase these activity levels. The simplest manner in which you could increase your activity levels is through walking. But you have to do it in such a way that it is not a chore. Core? Chore? Anyways, how does walking compare to regular cardio? The problem with regular cardio is that it causes a lot of fatigue and stress on your muscles and joints if done too often. And for most, it is boring and hence very difficult to adhere to. However, you can still include a couple of sessions a week, always good for your heart health. Would regular cardio burn more calories? For sure it would for a given length of time. However, you could go for a walk for a lot longer time with relatively little effort. After some time, you might even find it enjoyable and look forward to your daily steps. Just think of it this way. If you can add 5,000 steps daily, you could end up losing an extra kilo or a kilo and a half of body fat in a month. This in the long term will make a huge difference in your fat loss goals. I am going to give you a few tips of how to get walking into your daily routine and exactly how you can manipulate it to lose your body fat. Think of walking as accumulating a step count for your day. Ideally, you would like to do at least 8,000 steps in a day and establish this as your baseline. Thereafter, increase or decrease this amount of steps depending on your goals. To count the steps, I would strongly suggest you pick up a fitness band. It is a really inexpensive tool which will go a long way in keeping you accountable. It will not only help you in counting your steps, but will also actually help you get motivated in hitting your goals. How you get your steps in doesn't matter, just as long as you collect them until the end of the day. You could choose to do your steps in shorter walking sessions, let's say after a meal, and make this a habit. Another useful thing which will contribute to your daily step count is if you try to incorporate it into your daily routine, such as if you go to some place like let's say a supermarket or the office, try to pick up a parking spot that is the furthest. This way, unintentionally, you will end up gathering some extra steps. If you find yourself sitting for too long, stand up and take a couple of rounds wherever you are. Keep a sort of goal that you will get up from your chair once every hour. You could even set up an alarm on your fitness band for this. When you go for a walk, you could choose to listen to some music or listen to podcasts so that you could be more productive and learn something new at the same time when you go for your walk. Not only will you be hitting your step goals, but also you'll be gaining some knowledge in the process. Also, another habit you can make is that whenever you receive a call or are in a telephonic meeting, you could stand up and walk while you are engaged in your conversation. Another thing I notice is in the gym, once we are done with our set, we tend to sit around mostly on our phone, waiting to recover for the next one. This time is also a great opportunity to add in some extra steps without dedicating extra time to walking. If you live in an apartment, always choose to take the stairs. If you live on higher floors, you could always walk up the first few flights and then take the elevator. You could also make walking a part of your social activity. If it interests you, you could join one of those walking clubs and make some new friends. This could end up being a really fun activity. If you are meeting up with someone, you could grab a coffee and go for a walk together and have a chat. To consistently lose weight though, remember that it all depends on Chico. Calories in, calories out. If you have stopped losing body weight, it means that either you have to reduce your food intake or you have to increase your steps. If you still are worried that you cannot lose body weight, click here and check this video out. It could be your insulin resistance. In the meanwhile, like, subscribe. Signing out, Dr. Rohan Fonseca.